All right, I'm at a completely different entrance to Swan Creek Park. Where I usually enter is on, what is it, Pioneer Ave? And you actually walk along the creek. And in order to get to the forested area, you really, really have to hike up a long distance. Long, long way. So I thought I'd try a different entrance. One that's by Salishan housing near there. And it's also, it's the parking lot that has a community garden by right by it. So I have no idea what to expect. Pretty flowers. Well, okay. Hey there. Well, maybe there's a way to get to park near here, and I could come via here next time. Let's just look. Or is this still that road that you can't really go down? No, that's a it's a road you can't really go down, so, all right. I mean, you can walk down, but you can't drive down, so. Yes, no bikes. What does this do? Oh. All right, well, this could, if I wanted to take this, if I brighten this up a little bit so you can see. Let's see something here. This would allow me to walk down to the creek level. Lots of twisty trails leading all the way down. But, Hey. Well, that wasn't right. Okay. All right. what I was really coming here for was to go to the forested area. But maybe that's still not possible to get to. Unless you park on 56, but then when you park there, they say it's for bicycles only, so. It's 80 something degrees today, so I'm not gonna go on a major hike, that's for sure. Let's just see what this brings. Glad I don't have scotch broom allergies, right? Oh, this is pretty. So many ferns. But so far there's been this road on the other side the whole time. It's like that road was open at one time to traffic, and then they decided to close it off. Well, more switchback trailing that leads down. That I'm not going to do in weather in the 80s. Very, very pretty. Wow, this is gorgeous. Getting a little bit up by mosquitoes, but well, still that road, still more to go this way. I'm surprised there's not a lot of people here. There are those two people that you saw earlier on in the video, you heard. I don't think I pointed the camera at them. But that seemed to have been it. Let's just see what this does here. Big anthill right here. Yeah, this will probably go down. I'm going to take a peek anyway. Yeah, this will... another set of switchback trails that lead downwards. Different time. On a cooler day, I'll gladly do that. Walking on broken glass. Well, these trails, I mean, when I look at the map, these trails, this trail I'm on goes a long, long way. And there's only so much time I can record with this camera at once. I hear some people anyway, so... I'm gonna turn around, but I will be back. I will definitely be back here. I'm glad to have learned there are other entrances. As I said before, I thought the only other entrance was on 56th, where it's bike trails. You're not supposed to walk on those, so... Yeah, this is really nice. wonderful smell of evergreen needles as well. Just before I started this walk, there's a musician that I occasionally work with, who I did some harmonies for a cover song, and he wanted me to take a very specific type of picture for the, I guess you call it the album art. And it's supposed to be me next with a blue sky behind me. And it's actually kind of hard to find places out here that there aren't trees in the way. I guess I could go to Rust and Way to get those kind of pictures. I also can't seem to find a way to take that kind of picture with my good camera, because it has to be just a certain distance away, and getting the focus right on that, because my most of my lenses are manual, so and holding it just on that angle, I wouldn't be able to see what I'm taking a picture of. So it needs to be taken with my phone. I believe he took his with a phone too, but strange that a photo that should be really easy to take is actually difficult. At least when you're obsessive like I am. Now this, my camera at any point may say, oh, I'm getting too hot, I'm gonna shut down. So we'll see. Yeah, I love this trail. We may not be very far away from a street that cars don't go down, but just a beautiful area. Just gorgeous. Hello. Whoa. I go hello and nearly trip over a piece of root sticking up. As I said, I had wondered why there weren't more people here. Beautiful walk. Just beautiful. Hello. Hello, Kitty. Yeah, you gotta kind of look down a little bit most of the time when you're walking on these kind of trails. Anytime it's gonna go diddy-doon. Ah, here's some more people. Well, maybe they're just people at their houses. Yeah, that's probably what it was. Yeah, I will definitely be coming back here. Yep, there's about 20-something seconds left, and it's going to do the auto stop, because it does that at just under 30 minutes. So if I don't continue the recording in a little bit, thanks for watching. Well, let's try to record just a little bit more. Not much battery left either. But the camera will probably say, hey, I'm too hot. But I wanted to try anyway, so. Yeah, I love this. Yeah, this is more along the lines of what I've been looking for. For since I mentioned roots, I've got that song, I've Got No Roots. Oh, what a cute dog. Hi. Beautiful day.
Yeah.
Little hot, but beautiful. And over here, it's not too bright. This is the community garden they've got here. Really nice, really great sized community garden. It's really cool. Yeah, what a cool area. A little dark for a moment, it'll be bright again. Yeah, I will be back here for sure. Interesting. The Pierce Transit, public transit, comes out to here, just right over there. That's cool. Yeah, I will definitely be coming back here. I'm so glad I decided to check it out. Well, thanks for watching.